Hello and welcome to another episode of Ask a Farrinarian. I'm Dr. Brian, and today we're starting a new two-part series to help you better understand colic in horses. In part one, we'll go over what's actually happening when your horse is colicking, as well as some times where there's a higher risk for colic. So let's just dive right in. The term colic refers to pain anywhere in the abdominal region. Most often this is tied into the GI tract, the stomach, and the intestines, both large and small. The GI tract itself is about 100 feet long, so there's no shortage of areas to have a problem. There can be some other causes of abdominal pain, like a mare who's cramping at the beginning of the heat cycle. But for this video, we'll just focus on the primary suspect in these cases, the digestive system. We also have a video that goes over how to recognize colic in your horse, as well as what to do while you're waiting for your vet, so be sure to check that out. Now, there are any number of ways to categorize colics. This is just my system. The first is there's too much going on or it's hyperactive. One common version of this is a gas colic. There's just excess gas being produced and it swells or distends the intestines and it's really painful. Another common culprit in this category is spasmodic. Just think cramping or diarrhea. The intestines are hyperactive and with each spasm that comes through, it's really painful. The second category of colic is basically the opposite of the first, and it's called ileus. Ileus is the term that applies when any part of the intestine is not moving along like it should. It's not contracting. There's nothing squeezing it off or choking. It's literally just sitting there. These tend to be really painful and very hard to manage and treat. We don't know what turned the intestines off, and it's really hard for us to turn them back on. So these usually end up in a hospital for some intensive care and management. The third category of colic is called impaction. It's just a traffic jam inside the tube. Most often this is caused by a wad or clump of food, but sometimes it can be caused by haystring, parasites, or even an intestinal stone. Dehydration plays a key role in this condition. Cut hay, whether it's grass or alfalfa, has significantly less water content than does fresh grass. This means that a horse needs to drink a lot of water to help move the feed along. Each intestinal wave that comes through as it's advancing the food along is also wringing the moisture out of that food like a towel. Now, this isn't a problem if the horse is drinking a lot of water because it's regularly chasing the food with that water. Problem arises if a horse starts from a point of dehydration, like a tired horse after a long sweaty ride, a horse that just doesn't want to drink as much as it should, like a horse that's cold or the water outside is cold, or a horse who just stops drinking completely, like a horse who's suffering from a mild colic. The food that's already in the intestines is still getting wrung out, but with no more water coming in, it tends to get too dry and jam up. Additionally, there are some natural choke points that tend to make this problem worse. The intestine several times will go from a diameter of about 6 to 8 inches down to about 2 inches with a tight turn. This is fine for horses who are grazing small meals of fresh grass all day, but causes a problem when we feed large meals of dry hay. Because of the necessity of water intake to properly move feed along, it's very common for a horse with a mild colic to become dehydrated and develop a life-threatening obstruction. To make matters worse, the longer that obstruction sits there, the more it's damaging the part of the intestines where it's stuck, and with each successive wave trying to push it along, it just gets drier and drier. Final category of colic is one of the scariest, and it almost always requires surgery. This is when the intestine itself moves somewhere it's not supposed to be or displaces. Another one, it can twist part or all of the way around. And then lastly, it's not uncommon for the intestines themselves to get clamped from something outside of the intestines, like a lipoma. It's a tumor that tends to grow on a big stalk and can get thrown over the intestines and will clamp it off from the outside, like a tetherball around a pole. Horses with intestines in these conditions get extremely painful. They get little, if any, relief from the sedation and the pain meds that we can give them, and overall get very bad very fast. Guts die quickly, and it's basically a transfer to surgery or euthanized situation. And there are a lot of times where we don't know what actually caused the colic, but there are some times where there's an increased risk of colic, like a sudden change in the diet or in the weather. A sudden change in diet is notorious for causing excess gas, cramping, diarrhea, as those microbes are adjusting to the new feed. Also, when there's a rapid drop in temperature, or when horses have access only to excessively cold water, they aren't as interested in drinking. Nobody wants ice water in a snowstorm. We like to make this problem actually worse by feeding them extra hay in a nice warm barn, but the water is outside in the cold. So again, we see that combination of eating but not drinking enough causing a problem. That brings us to the end of part one. Make sure to check out part two when we go over treatment and management of colics. I hope you learned something. If you did, please share it. As always, thanks for watching.